I like to come to these old bluffs. They bring back a lot of inspiration. I'd just like to have seen this old country about 1880 and really known what it was like. Yeah, we take care of about 2,300 acres down through here. We run about 80 mama cows on it. I can come down here and solve the problems of the world. My name is Kent Rollins. I live in Hollis, Oklahoma. Cowboy, cowboy poet, and a cook. I actually started writing poetry probably about 1984. And I was horseback down here on the river, and things just sort of went to coming through my mind of things that I'd see about the countryside. And I got home one evening and just got to writing it down. Smoke billows upward and disappears like a gray ghost in the night. Soon smoke gives way to flames and embers start burning bright. Well, I think most of all the things that influences my work is being a poet or a storyteller.
Sourdough biscuits in an old cast iron oven soon will start to rise.
Sure, from the ranching industry part of it.
You see, cattle and cowboys, they've always been my life. It's sort of like a union between a man and his wife.
But a lot of it, too, comes from the old-timers that I was around when I was small, to get to be around those fellas and relive some of the stories that they told me. You really have to admire those people.
When you come down here to this old river and you sit, and you can look around you, and this old country hadn't changed no whole lot since the 1880s and the time when all the cattle drives were coming through. It gives me more of a peace of mind to know that what I'm still doing to make my living, and that's be a cowboy, when I can come down here and fit into something that's already here, it just makes it that much easier to be inspired by something that you see. If you can capture something down in line to where it looks when you get through telling it, it reminds people of a picture, well, you've sort of got your message across, I think. Getting better all the time, ain't you?
Pulled my old horse up to let him catch his air. While to get me up here on top, he had already done his share. The top of this old river rim is skirted with mesquite, sage, and shining there in the evening sun, well, it's like colors God painted on a page. The river there that lay below, it shines like brand new glass. And in my mind, I begin to wonder at the many things this old river had seen come to pass. Many a cow and cowboy this old river had seen them cross. Many a cow and cowboy this old river had claimed their loss. Say you come to this old river, and maybe if by chance you sit there quiet and you listen, you can almost hear them Kiowas dance.
It may be late one evening, right at dusky dark, when the wind has quit a blowing and them old cows have begun to bark. You see a herd of cattle bedded down on the Texas side, and you hear an old cowboy singing a night herd song. It'll fill your heart with pride.
Say you are drifting like a tumbleweed in the wind, looking for a new place to start, but you just don't know where to begin. I guess you can do as I, and every day I come to this river for a brand new start. You see, it's not a boundary at all, but a gate that'll open your heart. A lot of the cowboy poetry and stuff that I write is serious, probably half and half, from serious nature to humorous to sometimes hilarious.
Get on. Hey, hey, get up, mama. Hey, hey, hey.
Many a day that I have spent hauling hay and fixing fence, many's the hour I've spent a straddle, bouncing my backside in the seat of a saddle. As far as me considering myself a great poet, there's a whole lot better.
Get out of them trees, get out.
As times went by, the chores haven't changed, but my old body has, it doesn't react the same. The spills and the falls, well, they begin to hurt more. Now each day's work seems like a whole month's worth of chores. This ain't Shakespeare.
And I had to read a little Shakespeare when I was in high school and just really couldn't relate to this feller. But my poetry's not like that. Watch your rocks, young'un. Has the ground got harder or am I insane? The things that used to be fun, they now cause pain. I think of the things that really do hurt. It's the irons in the saddle that seem to be the worst. Feels like there's a rock in the middle of my seat that sends a sharp throbbing pain from down to my feet. I wanted it to be to where anyone could understand it. You didn't have to be a cowboy per se to know what I'm talking about. From the common, ordinary person to the old cowboy that's worked on a ranch for 70 years, I want somebody to be able to get something out of it, no matter what lifestyle they lead.
He tells it like it is. He ain't like these people that, you know, read it out of a book, dream up something, you know.
I've coped with this problem for quite some time and was ready to find a solution to this agony of mine. I called the doc in an appointment I made. Might have been a little embarrassed, but I sure wasn't afraid. I explained to Doc this little problem of mine, and he said, slip into this little gown. Everything's gonna be just fine. Well, this little gown, it didn't seem to fit, and the part left sticking out was the part where I sit. I lay there on the table, my backside in the air. I said, hang on a minute, Doc, is that necessary? Does that part need to be bare? Oh, he said, this problem you've got, it's really nothing to avoid. It's really quite simple. It's a thing we call a hemorrhoid. A hemorrhoid? Well, Doc, what might be the cure? He said, nothing major, but we're gonna have to cut it off, that's for sure. Cut it off, I cried with fright. Hang on a minute, Doc, I think a second opinion might be right. Second opinion? Well, I really don't think there's a need. Well, that's when I gathered my hats and boots, and from his office I left with a sudden burst of speed. Felt as I was lucky to get out of there with my life, because no doc gonna get near my backside, especially with a knife. As for this little problem, I ain't got rid of it yet. One thing's for certain, I won't go back to that crazy vet. There's so many things that inspire me when we do cowboy work, whether it be from horses to cattle to shipping time to cooking, to an old fence post to brand new baby calves. It's something that just is sort of sticks out in your mind. I think in life, in anything you do, it's better to be able to have lived something if you're trying to get that point across to people, because it's real, it's not fake, it's authentic, and that's what I think people like to hear. I guess in a way I'm drawn back to the old times. Some of the old ways that the cowboys had was not easy. It was hard. Calf fries. The benefits of morning work. We still go and cook on some working ranches during spring works. Sourdough biscuits. If you got beans, you got to have biscuits. And Cookie always had sourdough. And you feed 12 to 15 cowboys on a normal working ranch crew, and you start over the next day. You know, this ain't no Hardee's, nor is it a Mackey D's. There ain't no drive-up window and a menu you won't see. You know, that's part of an old poem we got. It takes hours and hours to prepare this food like old Cookie did, especially when you're feeding large groups. We'll have, besides beans, cherry cobbler, peach cobbler, sourdough biscuits, New York strip steak, and baked potato. So I think we're gonna eat a little better than them boys did back on trail drive. The people that settled this country years ago, everything was cooked in a Dutch oven. Coals underneath, coals on top, till they got old wood-burning stoves. Y'all come and get it. People will have to have a little entertainment to make the job go better. Sure, we make a living at it. This is what we do besides ranching and cowboying, is cooking and entertaining. So what do you think?
I think it's wonderful. I think old Kent's a wonderful cook.
I mean, I wasn't there 125 years ago to know what happened around the old cattle camps at night. And that's an old rabbit or a possum that's been run over about 170 times and baked in the hot Oklahoma sun till he's like a frisbee with fur on him. But I'll nearly guarantee you there was somebody there who told stories. There was somebody there maybe wrote a little poetry.
My shirt off and boots found me a feature.
To be able to pass this on maybe to another generation is to get to preserve and relate a part of America's heritage.
Had nobody died yet, so we're in pretty good shape this trip.
Stands there below the hill, a vision from the past. Once a sturdy structure, but now it's fading fast. Made of rock and mud, it once stood proud and tall, but now the chink is crumbling, the walls have begun to fall. These rocks, they came from the Wichita Mountains. They hauled them by the wagon loads, but now there's not even a trace of a wagon or a road. Built by a Texas cattleman, a headquarters for his spread, is miles and miles of grass he had from the Salt Fork to the Red. Many a herd of cattle this man turned out to graze as he fought life's many battles and his family he tried to raise. Well, I bet this old rock house was mighty a welcome sight when he had been gone a horseback and was trying to get home for night. As he rode up to the door, well, I can almost hear his little wife say, "Johnny, your pa's home. Go unsaddle his horse and throw him a bite of hay." Well, she met him at the door with a kiss and a smile, for he had been gone, seemed like an awful long while. She asked with a trembling voice, "How did it go?" He said, "Well, it could have went better, but I guess I didn't have much choice. You see, now I lost a bunch there at the river. It was running fast and deep. Maybe I should have picked me a spot where the banks weren't so slick or steep. By the time I got the rest to market, the price had went way down, and when I got through paying the bills, well, there weren't enough money for all the folks in town." "How will we make it?" she said. "We never will get by. I just want to quit and go home. I don't even want to try." About that time, I heard somebody holler, "Youngin', are you going or not? Get back on that old horse. We still got to get these cows to the lot." Well, I reached for my old reins and swung in the saddle to take a seat. As the sun was sinking fast there in the west, I turned to look once more. Was it really there, or was it gone? Or was it a vision from the past? I'm always happy to see a sunset. It means it's getting close to going home time. As long as there's cows and as long as there's cattle, I think there'll always be a need for a cowboy. There's a $1 million sunset every night if you just get to see it, and I'm fortunate to get to see a lot of them.